Hunter should be good for us. We have so many one drops and stuff. Only one Unleashed is actually like not the greatest, but it's not the worst either. One bow is pretty sweet. Ledge Zoo, you can do a lot of work. You can find like Haunted Creeper or something to go with this. It's pretty sweet. Or one drop. May keep the Juggler just because I'm sick of drawing three drops. Let's see.
I just want cards that I can play.
Every time.
Every time.
This is why I keep the Juggler, just so I make sure that there's cards in my hands that I can actually play. Because we know we're mulling into every 3-drop in the game. Oh, I'm dying bored. Getting some good early game pressure though. Nets Beats takes the lead, going to 12. I'm solidly in last place now. Interesting choice with the Leopard over there. We have the Beast here. Okay, I just wanted to take more damage. I'm okay with that. No problems. Alright, we got him down to 3. If any minion sticks, we are able to kill him with simply our hero power. Alright, this time he pings the crest bin. Let's make the all face one as well, so that I can switch between the two at my leisure and keep people confused with the traps. Alright, good. Some variety here. So it's not all the same thing, you know? Mixing it up, back and forth and stuff. I don't need any more packs. I have all the cards I need for this class. But I will do the free arena pack thing on my next class. Look for minions. Got a few. Mid-range costs a lot of dust. I want my second deck to be really good. This deck, I want to just be okay. Alright, we can't beat turn one Manaworm. That's probably the game. Oh shit. This whole turn was ping pass. Probably beat that. Nice, we just developed this guy. I mean, like, we could coin this guy and trade, but I don't really want to do that. He didn't miss his last turn, I'm hoping he just doesn't have it. Big pass again, that's really good for us. Sweet. Got like a lot of ping targets now, so that's pretty sweet. I don't know how that ended up working out, but now our whole board dies to a flame waker, but why didn't he play these cards? What's going on, man? Alright, let's get this guy out there. Juggle. More minions, better? Probably. He's playing Mech Mage, so As long as there's no mechs on the field, he shouldn't have missile effects, so more minions is better. More trades, more stuff, more things. It's less concentrated firepower. Right, we really need a minion now. Okay. Tempo out. I'm gonna tempo out this guy. Try and get in there for some damage. If we can close the health gap really fast, then maybe it doesn't matter. He's only got Annoyatrons in his deck for taunt, and like we have Unleashed that can beat that. He appears to have a very big high end in his hand because he's been doing a lot of big bass. So. Alright, good. The other explosive trap. Perfect. Maybe we will have a minion next turn. One can hope. Ooh, that's good for me. Oh, there's a minion. We got him. It's about damn time. Catch up. Tied for a sec. Everybody else. It's pretty close, Rage. Nope, can't turn up the mic, it doesn't go any louder. Production value. We're playing not the better one against Druid. The other one's much better against Druid, but if Druid starts becoming a common thing, we can switch to the other one. Druid's gonna be faster than Face Hunter. Well, that would be great if I could play Druid, but I can't. Get in there and fight, maggot. So if the Hunter class could play aggro Druid, that would actually be a really helpful tip. Turn one rope. Turn one rope, coin aspirin. That was a tough decision for you, right? A lot of plays you want to do that turn, but only one of them. Brighter. So I guess I'll probably have to concede this game and lose my win streak just so I can continue doing the race. Because we're gonna get roped every single turn, and then he's gonna do the best possible play in the game. Alright, there's probably no way we win anyway. Alright, trying to find some 2-drops and stuff. Got him. 2-drops. And stuff. The whole package. And I'm gonna coin my 2-drops and then I'm gonna play my stuff. I'm gonna start with Haunted Creeper because it's pretty good against mini bot, whereas Juggler is not. Try and pop my creeper on whatever he plays next turn and then use that to be able to develop the knife juggler and stuff.
Let me think.
The value trade here. Too much of an extension to consecrate though. Am I supposed to care with this deck though? I feel like all my other plays are just like too weak. Alright, so take some risks here. Do it this way. Higher percent chance to hit a minion. I tried to sneak in extra damage this way, but ended up getting burned. Sneak in one extra damage that way. So. Oh man, he overwrites his Coghammer. He's unable to kill the juggler now. Well, the juggler knows the game plan, I guess. That's what we switched to after some interesting juggle experiences. I guess he's got a Yobot in his hand or something. Otherwise this line just doesn't make any sense. Am I supposed to try and get another bow charge here, or am I just supposed to swing in this place? I need to get this out of my hand anyway, so I guess I can go for the other bow charge. We got next turn 3, 6, 9, 10, 11. We can kill him over two turns, so That's like fast enough, right? So I guess I don't care about Blue Charge. I just want to get it in before he taunts. It's more likely he taunts than he heals, right? And then we do this, this, and then that, that. And then we get him.
Who am I? None of your business.
Yeah, that would have been a bummer if we didn't swing at the bow. Very glad I did that. So now I just gotta kill him before he kills me. Which should happen most of the time, if he doesn't magically heal. If I can get this out of my hand while doing the damage to set up for lethal. So that I have the quick shot cycle. If things get weird. Hopefully none of the Murlocs heal him. Good, good.
Right there.
No ice block from the Paladin.
No, I'm new.
Maybe the other deck better than you. Honor Creeper can test that pretty good. Knife Juggler is like too much of a good skill. But I'd rather be able to play with the Abusive Sergeant next turn. Just screw up this Coin Animal Companion real good.
Like he's got a Phoenix Shaman.
That's so good. No, no, it's a bear. Oops. That's a card. Maybe not the best play by me then. Forgot Bear Trap's a card. It's okay, our bear's bigger. Got him. Even if he killed Commands, we're still in a favorable position. People play Bear Trap. I guess I don't really want to overextend too much into like Unleash Shenanigans. Or do I? Like, maybe it's right. I don't have very many cards. Yeah, I think this is good. Just go for the consistent damage output instead of trying to overextend and Unleash or whatever. It's like not a bad board in this way. We don't just get blown out and then have no minions to repopulate since we drew so many damage spells. Start swinging weapon charges immediately, only drawn to the other weapons. Probably do just trade this thing down, right? Yeah, guess we're losing to Unleash if he has it, right? The full extension, though? I mean, like, what am I do? Hold back the abusive sergeant to repopulate with just abusive? Like, that just doesn't make sense, so... He's not gonna hold enough weight on his own, so let's just die to Unleash. There's no way he has it. Except this time. Oh shit. Did we get it? Oh shit. I made the read. Kappa. I can't read. So we need Haunted Creeper to live, so then we have 8. Everything else can die. But Haunted Creeper's a bro. He's gotta live. Oh, crap. I don't think he can kill me, and he better not be running a heal bot. Why would you help the creeper? Doesn't make any sense, man. There's no way he clears that old board and the creeper. I like can't think of a card combination that makes any sense. There might be some garbage one that makes no sense, but... I think we're pretty safe on that front. Ah, damn it, I forgot to dodge. Alright, alright, just the hunter. Seems good for me. Most of the time. So I'm just clearly gonna draw my curve better. 1-2. Haunted Creeper's like super important in this matchup. Two of them might be overkill. He kept 3 cards, we're dead. Alright, we find a 3 drop, we're good to go. That beats Worgen Infiltrator, but Haunted Creeper eats that. Leaf Chain is real. So we hold on to the Worgen, maybe need some value trades on something or another. Okay. I guess I want to develop the other Haunted Creeper and just stop as much damage as I can. Which is this. Otherwise the 1-2 could die trade into my 1-1s this way. Better position. Hopefully he doesn't be able to trade here and then like unleash and then trade all and be able to 3-1. It's weird. Oh man. Now we get to play Trap Roulette. It's gonna be snakes every time, but you get to do what you get to. Oh my, it's not snakes. So, explosive or bear. To play around bear, we develop Shredder first. He's playing like weird things like Lance Carrier, so you know it's bear. So I'm gonna develop here and then attack next turn and then deal with the bear later. Respecting the bear trap. Like, if I'm super confident about bear. Alright, whatever. As it's pressing. mean, I could kill the bear this turn and poke in one, but I think the knife juggler is probably more valuable. Do it next turn. Alright, let's see. Are you a bear? Nope, I was just wrong. Alright, set up lethal. Hope he doesn't have it. Number two, but this guy still lives, right? So we tag with this one first to beat bear. It's the other way, like misdirection. Wait, are we gonna attack this one first and then kill command it? Yeah, we can just kill command the bear if it's a bear, so that's fine. We tag this one first. I just didn't want to die to misdirection or something weird, you know? So, got there. Alright, 13. Caught back up-ish. Past Raynad. Way behind Sabitz. One rank man, please. always kings. Damage and then kill him, and if he draws damage and kills me, like if I don't, then he does it to me. So we're just playing the old whoever draws damage first wins game, unless he tries like value trade or something. Hopefully he doesn't have the ability to. So we got a bunch of cards to kill him, and he's got a bunch of cards that he can probably top deck to kill me. He's probably got one damage card and he needs two to kill me, and I have zero and I need one to kill him. Okay, 4, 5, 6, 7, that's gonna do it. So yeah, we're both just stop decking damage there. The old Hearthstone though. I don't know why he made the hero power. He didn't make the hero power unleashes in and out, so that was kinda sloppy. Now I wait to play against the winner of the other two. I guess I can check that out. Alright, well I'm gonna use the bathroom while I'm on break and get more water, so...